Hi there, welcome to Mini Math Lessons with Karen. Today I'm using the Casio fx300ESPlus scientific calculator, second edition, and it looks very similar in layout to many of the other scientific calculators that we have, which is great because if you already know where the buttons are or what the buttons do, you're not having to learn anything new. So we like to be very consistent at Casio. So what I want to do today is just kind of show you some cool features that you may not have realized that these calculators have. So I'm looking at two activities. So I'm sharing these. You'll see the links below. One's called Sharing Candy and one is called Rationals versus Polygons. And this first one is basically kind of about reasoning, but it has fractions and having students really picture what fractional parts are, how do you divide something, how do you then calculate if you need to, but it's more about understanding what they are and then comparing equivalent forms. So fraction, standard notation, decimal, mixed number, even remainders. So here's this lesson, and it starts off with, you know, if you're a teacher, this is really nice because it actually has standards and goals, practices, and then some things that you need to do or that you can extend. The first part I really like is very open-ended. They're talking about students sharing a candy bar and how would you divide it among five people. So it's kind of letting the kids show what they already know about fractions. They have to draw a model, and then they have to show some calculations that they can prove that their model's right. So it starts off with this, and as a teacher, you might be going through this and have different students compare their answers. And then once they get a sense of that, then we move into some practice types of problems where they're actually going to be dividing fractions, and they can use their calculator, but you're really trying to develop an understanding of things. So I just wanted to make sure that we all know how to use the calculator buttons here. So in this first problem, let's just do this. You have 2¾ cups, so how do you enter that number? So you can, if you look, here's this decimal over here, you see the yellow. So if you look above the yellow, that's a shift. So over here we have a fraction and above it is the mixed number. So if I hit shift first, it sets up the template for me so I can actually put those values in. So this is the great thing about having standard notation in a calculator. You can actually make the numbers look the way they look in the problem, which sometimes can be so confusing to a student if it doesn't look exactly the same. So there's 2¾ and we have to divide it three different ways, divide it by three. So we're going to divide by three. So typical problem, what's that look like? When we hit equals, we end up with a fractional result, 11 over 12. And this is where you have the ability to toggle 0.91 repeat. So this helps students start realizing the equivalency between and this is an extended form, and then if we go back, we have the fraction. So it's really nice. They actually get fractional answers, and then if they've already been working with models, that's easier for them to see is the fractional. It's 12 parts. I have 11 of them. Each part is 11. So those types of things are going to be working on here. And one of the things I like right here, I'm going to go to number 7 because I want to show you another feature of the calculator. This is talking about having 68 students and 3 teachers that need to travel to a field trip, and every van holds 14 people. So how many people is that? First of all, 68 plus 3 is 71, right? So there's 71 people that have to go in vans. Every van only holds 14. So how many vans do we need? So if we go back to our calculator and we have 71 people and we are going to divide by the 14 that each van holds, when I hit equals, I get this strange fraction here. So it's an improper fraction. So that doesn't help me. I'm trying to figure out how many vans. So here is where, if you notice up here, we can toggle between standard and decimal. So if I hit this right now, I see the decimal version. So 5 vans. And so a lot of students might say, well, 5 vans, right? So 5 vans is all I need. But what's this extra mean? What does that extra mean? And this is where we can really help them kind of make a sense of this. So let's go and use our shift button and toggle it to a improper fraction. So again, here's my 5. And then I have 1/14th left over. Well, what did 14 represent? 14 represented the people. So I have one person out of the 14 left. So I have this one person who's not able to get on one of the vans. So is my answer really 5? And hopefully they see that. But there's another tool in this calculator, which is really nice. And if you look above here, it says divide by are. That means divide, and if there's a remainder, it will show the remainder. So let's do the same problem, but this time we're going to use this button instead of the divide button. So we're going to do 71, and we're going to do shift divide by R. So this is saying I want a remainder. I want to see what the remainder is, if there is one. And now we're going to hit 14 again. And notice now it's 5 with a remainder of 1, which matched that 5 and 1/14. But now we can think about this. This is 5 vans. I have 1 person left over. So my answer isn't 5 vans because I'm going to need to have that extra person, right? So I really need 6 vans. So these are the kinds of nice things that you can really use this calculator for, is to help students understand what all the, what's the decimal, what's that really mean in context. So this is the first activity, and we're going to scroll to the second activity over here. So this one is rationals versus polygons, and again, it is the, it's got the nice standards up here, it's got suggestions on what you can do and what to ask. And then this one starts off with two teams that are basically playing football, but the field's divided by fractions instead of our 100-yard line. And so basically this is working with fraction operations, so they can see that. And then it's also getting into some positive and negative. So they're learning what happens if I multiply a positive times a negative number, what happens if I have a negative times a negative. So they're really exploring integers. So if you look up here, again, this is really focusing on the ability to write problems as they appear. So for example, if I look at this F here, I can actually enter exactly as I see it. So I see negative 2 halves, negative 2.5, right? So I'm going to enter that. And then it's being divided by, and then I'm going to hit that shift and that button again, negative 3, and I'm using the arrow keys to get myself back up and down in the numerator and the denominator. So if I want to go to the denominator, click down. So the ability for these calculators to show the actual standard notation is fantastic. And then when you hit the answer, you see the answer in standard notation, but you can then toggle and see it in its decimal form, and we can toggle back. And so it goes through lots of things. So it's a great way to explore equivalent fractions, and notice equivalent fractions, but equivalent forms of a number, decimal, fraction, irrational, those types of things. Notice I did a negative times a negative, and I ended up with a positive. And so that's part of this exploration as well, is what are you noticing when we have these negative values being multiplied by negative? Why are they positive? And then they could go back up to their situation up here when they were moving the teams on the line, what happened when they went positive direction, negative direction. So this is really all about, not only about fractions and decimal equivalents, but also about positive and negative. So using this calculator is really nice because of its ability to, has a really nice screen for a scientific notation, scientific calculator. It has a really nice wide screen so you can actually see the fractions and the standard notation. So just a little bit of support on this and what these lessons are about. So have fun.